I'm Sean Darty, and this is my key assessment community paper highlights. I'm doing my project on Putnam County, the place that I currently live in New York State. Putnam County is a beautiful area to live in that has a caring community, many natural resources, and a great location, according to Kevin Owens, chief of police for the town of Kent. This county has one mental health provider for every 1,780 residents, and had a population of 97,936, according to a survey done on Putnam County back in 2021. On a 10-point scale, in which 1 was not very important at all, and 10 was very important, mental health services were given an average importance rating of 9.26 by community leaders. A problem worth addressing: on any given day, there are several patients coming into the mental health system in need of support. Many of these people have a job or are in school, like the average citizens, and hospital systems have standards for treating people who come in with a mental health concern, which includes keeping the patient overnight for 5 to 7 days, and seeking to find psychotropic medication that they suggest might help their patients stay out of hospital systems for psychiatric reasons going forward. This hold can negatively impact someone's school and work schedules and frustrate the patient in the process. What the mental health system is like: when going to a hospital that has a mental health focus, you could come in for dizziness and end up staying for psychiatric reasons, despite having a healthy mental health state, especially if you have a diagnosis or a record of having been to mental health facilities in the past. Once admitted, you are locked in until the doctor gives the right of way for you to be discharged. While in their care, they seek to find what kind of mental health-related issues pertain to you, including drug usage, depression, mood swings, and others. And with a diagnosis, they push medications that have a record of helping some people as part of their medical practice. And I do mean practice here, because these medications work differently for different people and tend to have bad side effects, very, very awful side effects. My mission is that while the system is functional, I believe that there are some changes that would benefit the entire system other than big pharmaceutical companies' wallets. What I recommend is that every patient entering the mental health facility be granted a therapist and a social worker. This therapist would give the patient the time they need to explain what has gone wrong for them in detail, within reason, maybe only a couple hours per day, and they would have to stay overnight if they needed to more than one session. I know that many people would benefit greatly from just having someone to listen to them and someone who would look to support them. The social worker is meant to provide resources should the therapist not suffice, and only after the therapist and the social worker meet with the patient to their content should they be locked in prescribed medications. In my history, when I first went to a mental health facility, I wasn't given the time of day to advocate for myself. I was only given about 5 minutes to summarize 7 months worth of problems. I find that when you go through the process of explaining what you have gone through, you reprocess the information, sometimes learning a new angle to approach from. And with the counsel of a therapist, I believe that many people would suffice with just that, at first, at least. Should problems persist further, more action should be taken. By giving patients an attempt to reorient themselves and establish a relationship with someone who could help advocate for them in the future, they would benefit patients greatly and perhaps shorten their stay to a few hours rather than several days. In conclusion, I believe that giving a talk therapy option before enacting an overnight stay or prescribing medication would make patients going through the mental health system appreciate the process far more, feeling less like a number and feeling like they have been seen and heard. When people have a problem, generally they seek to solve the problem with some natural methods before turning to medication, and I believe that this approach should be the first step in mental health systems as well. This would distribute the resources to the therapists and social workers who work directly with the patients rather than directly to the pharmaceutical business, at least at first, and it would create a more welcome first step for the whole process. Here are my references, and that's my project. Thanks. Bye.